full meaning of back is value added tax. So value added tax. The first thing that we have to do is that we have to look at what is the meaning of value added tax. They say value added tax. You see how a value created. You see, if you buy something in business, you are going to sell it for 40 cents. You have added a value of 20 cents. That is fine. That is our value added tax. We want to tax that. So value added tax is an indirect tax. But this tax is being imposed on the consumption of goods and services. So at the end of the day, the burden of value added tax is being imposed or being incurred by the consumer. So these tax are being imposed on your goods and services. So if you go to the market and buy something like this, you are paying a value added tax on your goods. So value added tax basically is a tax imposed on consumption of your goods and services. So the basic meaning is that if you're not able to consume those goods, you're not going to get any value added tax. But why do you are paying value added tax on your goods? Because you're paying the goods to the market and buy this for you. But in this case, you are paying to your mother or to your father. So this is basically a value added tax. You say value added tax is an indirect tax. Why are we saying it's an indirect tax? Because you are paying it to download it. That is no specific way to understand. You will be able to determine that you are paying this tax or this one. But if you grant the income tax, there is a fixed rate there, 15% or 20%. You know what you pay, you pay it. You see that once you pay. But this one, you can't differentiate this one between the actual price and the listing. So it's an indirect tax. So basically, that is value added tax. Value added tax is the price of consumption of goods and services. That is basically an value added tax. Let's look at some of the uses of that. As I said earlier, that is an indirect tax. Why do I say an indirect tax? You pay without knowing. You won't feel the budget. You are paying with it. Because you can't be able to tell you how much you pay. But if it should be income tax, you feel it out. This is another pay. So, one of the features, or the first one is that is an indirect tax. The second one is being imposed on. It's imposed on consumption. Consumption of goods and services. So if you don't consume your goods, you won't pay it. So those who are consuming, they are going to pay. So what is basically incurred by the consumer. Consumer, you are going to be the one to pay. So because you are going to consume the goods. Another one is that is a multiple. It's a multiple stage tax. Why do you say multiple stage tax? You go to the market and buy something, you pay tax, you pay VAT. You come and sell it to someone, that person will pay tax. That person also will go and sell it to someone, that person also will pay tax. And that person can also go and sell it until the final monthly owner consumer. The tax will be compiled into the lease and multiple stage. Then the producer will go to the market. So from the producer, it goes to the wholesaler. The wholesaler also goes to the price of the Then the wholesaler will send it to the retailer. The retailer also pays the price of it and the final consumer will money. So it's a multiple stage tax. And it has been is collected by a registered one. You can't just stand up and say you are charging part or you are collecting part. No. You have to go to the revenue authority. In Ghana, we call it the Ghana Revenue Authority. You have to go to them and obtain the VAT credit. They will give you the VAT receipt explicit. So you are going to. So it's not everyone that can collect VAT. You are registered for the VAT. So those of you that will be charging people that are charging VAT because you just want to increase your prices. So in the law, yes, we are going to be sorry. So this is one of our facts. But let's look at the actual facts. That is the topic for the facts of facts. Basically, we have two kinds of facts. The first one is the input facts. We have input facts. We have output facts. Okay. Input means the raw materials, things that we go into the production process. So if you go and buy raw materials, as you do a manufacturing company is going to buy raw materials to produce. The company will be back to the purchase of the raw materials. So we call it input. So this is always purchases. It is always on purchases. The output, it is being placed on the finished product. So this is always on purchases. It is always on research. So input value is being calculated on purchases, and output value is being calculated on sales. But let's assume that it is a company. It is a company of ABC Limited going to buy raw materials to produce. So going to buy the raw materials, the ABC will pay a part. Let's assume that the margin is 15%. Let's assume that the margin is 15%. So ABC will get what? What will be? But markets at the moment, but 5 minutes, 5 minutes for 5 minutes at $20. And so the 5 minutes at $20. So what will happen is that. So, first thing, if you take a VAT machine, the first thing that you have to come to yourself is that how is the VAT calculated? The amount that the person is paying, is the VAT already included or the VAT is excluded? So, sometimes the question is the VAT includes, means that the amount of money that you need to what is already included in it. But sometimes they say VAT excludes, that means you are yet to calculate the VAT on that amount. So, this one, let's assume that it is VAT excludes. So, we are saying that this will be purchased. This will be purchased. So let's assume that this is compact. This is compact. And this is also compact. This is also compact. The ABC Limited is going to take the back to the company that you want to have. And the consumer who the ABC Limited will be selling the goods to also pay the back of this goods to ABC. So let's assume that. This will be purchases, this will be sales. So they say the VAT is 15%. So what will happen is that we have to find the total price of the 5 markets. So we find the total price of the 5 markets. We are going to have the company we should pay. Why should we have the way to find this particular transaction? What 5 markets at the business age? Okay. Let's assume that we are buying from account itself. So we are going to have purchases account and purchases account. Because you are buying it. So we have purchases account. Purchases account, which will be a purchase in the name of the purchase. And now we find the total amount, 5 times this one. So maybe it's divided by 20 account. 20, 500. Then we come to the purchase account. We have purchases should be 100. The ABC will be paying a part of 15% on $100. So we have to calculate the input part because it's purchases. We have to calculate the input part of the input part. So the input part will be 15% times $100. So this will give us $15. Who? The ABC will be paying a batch. The ABC will be paying a batch for creditor. So it's a creditor that normally collects. It's always a creditor that collects the income tax. We have a creditor that comes. We have VAT, which will be 15. What is happening? This person is paying out. ABC is paying out. So this will become an expense to ABC. So since this is an expense, I will go to input value account or VAT account. We have 15 as the corresponding issue. Let me open my account here. So I have this one, the name of a credit card, and I have it this here. This should tell us. Are we okay? Are we okay? Okay. Let me take this thing off. So let's go. Yes, exactly. We need to choose 5 packets at this one. 30 each on credit. So this one is to be sales and debtor. So they come to sales account. So we have to see. So this one we find a contract. This one is 35. So we have debtor. We have 50. Here are the debtor. Then we come to debtor's account. This is the credit that this one itself. So, yourself, you know, then we need to have to find because the vector will be the vector of the part. So, we can build the half part. We can build the half part. We can build the half part, which will be 15% minus 1 to 2 minutes. That will give us. Always on sales figure, and the input part is always on purchases figure. So if ABC Limited bought numerous stationaries, what you are going to do is that you just sum up all the stationaries to get the total purchases, then you can build a part of it. If you also sold a numerous number of stationaries, you sum up all their value, then you have the total sales, then you can build a part of it. So at the end of the day, you pay the part of 50 cents to the person that we bought the thing from. At the end of the day, we collected a bunch of $22.5. What are we going to do? We get a special 50 cents and now we are getting 22. So in this case, we just have to take the one that we paid from this one. We just have to take the 15 from this one because we paid the value of this one. We paid the value of 15. And we are collecting 22. So at the end of the day, we have to set off the one that we paid against the one that we received. And that will be the net VAT payer, net VAT payer. This can also be negative. It can happen that we pay more than this, and that will be a VAT refund for you, and that will be an asset. So you pay more than what you receive. That means the VAT payer is only you. If you pay less than what you receive, that means you have to send the difference to the VAT authority. So let's look at the net. That net VAT payable is the difference between the output VAT, what you receive and what you pay. So the output VAT is 22.5, and the input VAT is what you pay. That is, we have 7.5. So this is the VAT that we are going to remit to the VAT authority. This is all about VAT accounts. VAT accounts know the types of VAT. We have output VAT and input VAT. We said that the output VAT is always on the sales, and the input VAT is always on purchases. So it will give you a list of items. Let's look at another example. It will give you a list of items. Then you sum them up. You get your total purchases. You can get the VAT amount of it. They will give you the VAT rate. And they also give you a sales figure and a list of sales made. Total it, then you calculate your VAT to get your output VAT. So this example that we are showing right now is VAT exclusive. That means VAT is not included. So we are here to charge the amount of it. Let's assume that we give the figure that VAT inclusive. So let's look at VAT inclusive figures. Let's look at example of VAT inclusive. So let's this one you can just give the total. Let's assume the sales. The sales is $2,005.
36 years. 2000 years. All that inclusive. All that inclusive. All that inclusive. The first thing is this. That's good. Yes. That's the next 15%.
Alright. So that means that the first program, this is what that does. When they have added a part figure to it, they have added a part figure to it. How do you get this figure? It is the actual sales figure plus the VAT amount on the sales delivered to the company. This is a small mass. So this is the actual sales figure plus the VAT amount. Give us the VAT amount plus the sales amount. Are we okay? Are we okay? Alright, so let's do some small mass. We have 100x plus 15x is equal to 2,100. This will multiply this, will multiply it. So we are going to have 115x is equal to 2,100. And something. Okay, let me just make it. Okay. This will give us 250,000. Alright. So we divide this around. So basically what one is, it is like it. It is 100x. Inclusive amount over the VAT. You add the VAT to 200, then you have this one. So this is a bigger deck. Let's get it. So this will give us 6, 6, 7. Okay. So this is the actual sales figure. This will be 2,174. That is the actual sales figure. That is the actual sales figure. Let me try that again. Okay. I'm correct. Okay, let's come to the purchases. So this is the actual sales figure. So this is the actual sales figure, which is 2,174. We want to get the output VAT. The output VAT will now be 2,100 and the actual sales figure. Now we give us 3,26. Let's determine the actual purchases we got. This will give us 100 times 2,000. 100,000 all our money. That would be nice. So the actual sales, purchases with that, actual purchases with that, give us 7,239. So what would be the input part? The input part would be this one, and this one, because the input part is already here. So, you do that. You get 261. 261, that is. That will be the input part. So, let's come here. Let's come here in this one for this account. So, if you come to the purchase list, you're going to have a credit card. So, if you take only the actual purchases, you're going to have a credit card. It comes with the latest figure, it is the purchases figure plus the VAT, so 739. because we are going to pay the fact to the creditor. So you have 261. So at the end of the day, this will be the 2000 naira debt. So you come to the part here, which is the this thing, let me bring the first part here. For this one, I'll leave at this one. Let me balance this one first. But let's do the under the action now. So if you have this one now, have the creditor to the 261. Then we bring the output part, which will be the debtor. 326. So let's come to the sales and the debtor's account. The actual sales is 2174. The bank is 326. Okay. So let's come to the sales here. I'm going to have a debtor. Debtor of 2700. So if we come to a net part account, it means that you pay a lot of 261, which is that. So the net part payout, we're going to have active part first, because we pay 8826. And then we have the net part. What we see in the output, what we pay, is that 13 over here, because you have to pay it of 13 amount of pay. You have to take account of pay. So we have the difference between 5, 6. So this is the value we are going to pay, or this is the value we are going to give to the value authority. This is the value we are going to give to the value authority. So this is all about value. So I said that it can also happen that when you pay more than what you receive, meaning that the value authority is owing us, so we are going to report that as an asset. But in this case, you receive more than what you pay. That is, you have to bring from the excess to the value authority. So in this case, this becomes a liability. So if you are giving the question, the first time you either the bank is inclusive or the bank is inclusive. If the bank is inclusive, it means that the bank